let us start with the second part of this chapter, that is the structure of a leaf. Come, let us understand the structure of a leaf. It is mainly divided into two parts, that is parts of a leaf and venation in a leaf. First of all, what are the parts of leaves? So leaves are mainly divided into three parts, that is leaf base, petiole, lamina. What do you mean by lamina? Lamina means leaf blade. Okay, lamina means leaf blade. Here it is, see. Now let us understand one by one. First one is leaf base. Now what do you mean by leaf base? This is the part where a leaf attaches to the stem. See, as you can see in the picture. Second one is petiole. What do you mean by petiole? Petiole is the thin stalk that links the lamina to the stem. Leaf ke niche stick part hota hai, see. This one, this part is known as petiole. This whole part is petiole. The third one is lamina. Lamina is also known as leaf blade. Okay, leaf blade is the green flat surface of the leaves. This whole flat surface is known as leaf blade. It also consists of small branched veins. See, as you can see, this is small branched veins. Okay, small branched veins. The vein that runs along the middle of the leaf blade is called the midvein. See, this is midvein. Okay, this is midveins. See, leaves grow from the knots on a stem. Leaves are generally thin, flat and green in color. The broad spread out part of the leaf is called the leaf blade or lamina. Just now I have told you, see, this is leaf blade or lamina, and its edge is called the leaf margin. Its edge, see its edge, this is its edge. Edge is known as leaf margin. Leaf margins may be entire, dentate or lobed. Leaf margins can be divided into three parts, that is entire, dentate and lobed. Let us study one by one. Now first one we have entire leaf margin. What do you mean by entire leaf margin? It means it has smooth margin. See, as you can see, its margin is so smooth. Now second one we have dentate leaf margin. What do you mean by dentate leaf margin? It means it has finely toothed margins. See, it has finely toothed margin. And the last one we have lobed leaf margin. It means leaves are those who have distinct projection. It ends are rounded. See, it ends are rounded. This is known as lobed leaf margin. See. So the tip of the leaf is called the leaf apex. Its tip is called the leaf apex. It may be tapering, pointed or rounded. Leaves of some plants have a stalk called a petiole. This is petiole. This stick is known as petiole. Okay. Leaves of some plants do not have a petiole. The portion of the leaf attached to the stem is called the leaf base. See, this portion is known as leaf base. Small leaf-like structure may be present near the leaf base. These are called stipules. See, the small leaves are known as stipule. It is present near the leaf base. Now next one we have simple leaf and compound leaf. What do you mean by simple leaf? When a single lamina is connected to the main stem by the petiole is known as simple leaf. Okay, see, it has single leaf blade connected with petiole. This one is known as simple leaf. this one is also simple leaf. This one is also simple leaf. Now next one we have compound leaf. What do you mean by compound leaf? It means when two or more laminas, that is leaf plates, are connected to main stem by a petiole, then it is said to be a compound leaf. So our next topic is venation in leaves. What is venation in leaves? What do you mean by venation? What do you mean by venation here? It means it is the arrangement of veins in the leaves. Veins जो pattern और design में बनते हैं उसको हम venation बोलते हैं. See here, यहाँ पे देखो leaves का venation कैसे बना है. कुछ यहाँ जा रहा है, कुछ यहाँ जा रहे हैं, right? और इसमें देखो सब parallel है. तो ये arrangement को हम बोलते हैं, ये design को हम बोलते हैं venation. See, veins helps in supporting the lamina, that is leaf blade, and in the transportation of water and food. Veins patti ko khada rakhne mein help karta hai, wo khana pani transport karta hai. They carry food and water. There are two types of venation, that is first one is reticulate venation and second one is parallel venation. Let us understand one by one. So the first one we have reticulate venation. In a reticulate venation, the veins are randomly arranged and form a complex networks. See here, the veins are randomly arranged. Okay, bikhre hue veins hai. Koi yahan ja raha hai, koi yahan ja raha hai. See, are randomly arranged and have a complex network. जब वीन्स का पैटर्न बिखरा हुआ रहता है और कॉम्प्लेक्स नेटवर्क बनाता है, यानी कि यहाँ वहाँ जा रहे हैं, उसको हम बोलते हैं कॉम्प्लेक्स नेटवर्क. फॉर एग्जाम्पल लीव्स ऑफ द रोज. ओके, सी द नेक्स्ट वन वी हैव पैरेलल वेनेशन. नाउ व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय पैरेलल वेनेशन? दिस वन इज वेरी इजी. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय पैरेलल? पैरेलल मीन्स स्ट्रेट लाइंस विच डू नॉट intersect. Okay, in the parallel venation, the veins run parallel to each other. See, कोई किसी को intersect कर रहा है नहीं. सब lines कैसे जा रही है? एकदम parallel में. For example, banana leaves. Okay, they do not touch each other. They always go parallel. Okay, they always go parallel. They do not touch each other. That is known as parallel venation. Venation means arrangement or design. Okay. So the next part is the flower. Now let us understand the functions of a flower. So the first function of the flower is, a flower helps in reproduction of plants. Reproduction means it is a process by which new organisms are produced from their parent organism. Now let us understand the parts of flower. Petal, sepal, stamen, pistil are all parts of a flower. Now first one is petals. This is the bright color part that attracts bees, insects and birds. So the color of the petals varies from plant to plant. For example, hibiscus flower have red petals, roses have red petals also, sunflower has yellow petals. So the next part is sepal. Sepal is the green color part below the petals. They protect the flower when it is a bud. जब flower छोटा रहता है तब उसको sepal protect करता है, as you can see in the picture. Now third part is stamen. It is the male reproductive organ of flower. It consists of two main parts, that is anther and filament. Now anther is like a sac structure which produces and stores the pollens. Small dust like particles necessary for reproduction, as you can see in the picture, that yellow one, sac structure, that is known as anther. Now next one is filament. It is a thin thread like tube which supports the anther. Can you see that green colored tube below the anther? That is known as filament. The fourth part we have is pistil. It is a female reproductive organ of a flower. It has three main parts, that is stigma, style and ovary. Now let us understand one by one. So the first one is stigma. It is the topmost part of the pistil, as you can see in the picture. Now second one is style. It is the long tube that connects stigma and ovary. The third one is ovary. It is a ball-like structure. वही ball के जैसा सी oval shape में दिख रहा है सबको. It contains the ovules. It is also the part of the plant where the seed formation takes place. The male reproductive part of the flower is known as androecium and the female reproductive part of the plant is known as gynoecium. Now let us understand the process of pollination. How does it takes place? First of all, an anther, which is a part of stamen, produces small particles called pollens. In the ovary, which is a part of pistil, produces particles called ovules. When the pollen goes inside the pistil and meets the ovules, then the ovule grows into a seed within a fruit. This process is called a pollination. It can be done by the help of wind or insects. The next part and the last part is the fruit. We eat many different types of fruit. Each type of fruit has its own characteristics. There are variations in their shape, color, taste, etc. Okay, every fruit has their own shape, size, taste, flavor, color. Mango contains only one seed, whereas jackfruit consists of many small fruitlets, each with its own seeds. Okay. We know that each fruit has a different skin or shell, fleshy part and seed. In case of fruits like cashew, its seeds is outside the fruit. Now soak the seeds of pea, wheat, rice, jowar, groundnut in water for 3 to 4 hours. Now press the seeds with your fingers and observe them. Which seeds get divided into two equal parts? Now see, seeds which get divided into two equal parts are called dicotyledonous seeds. Seeds which do not divide it into two equal parts are called monocotyledonous seeds. Okay, mark this point as important from here to here. So here we have completed the chapter 2.